No, we didn't know each other. We actually met through Instagram. And she's literally a kindred spirit to me. And I felt that all the way from LA, so it's great to feel the confirmation. No, we didn't know each other.
Yeah, we didn't know each other. I mean, sometimes you just meet a person and you feel that there's a spirit and you catch the vibe. And we didn't even speak, yeah. We just wrote. Yeah. So once he sent me the record, the version that he did, it was like we were friends or like old souls that
for sure
came together.
But I won't always be there.
Okay, well, Be Here in the Morning sort of shifted once I decided I would like to do a duet. First of all, it was more like a song about family members and a friend of mine. And I wrote it with Sway Clark. I was on the phone with my family and I was a bit stressed out about like little stuff that happened, and I went back and told Sway, and so we started writing this song. And I was hoping for you to jump on the record. Mm-hmm. You just totally, obviously, transformed it into a love song.
First got the record, it intimidated me, I told you this, because it's unlike anything that I ever did before. I do like rock and roll, blues, and this was a challenge for me because if you listen to my music, I have nothing like this. Like nothing at all. So I was like, man, am I gonna be good enough?
Of course.
I literally doubted myself so much. I did like so many takes of the verse and I was like, man, maybe I'm not the right person for it.
Really? That's what you thought at some point?
I did, because I was like, I really think this is an amazing song. I don't want to mess it up.
Wow.
And literally I was like, let me do one more take. And that's the take.
And that was that.
Man.
To me, you're just an old soul. When I hear your voice, I hear like a very, very, very old soul speaking out of it. And I think that was what I was looking for.
For sure.
I loved the song before, or I liked it. And then when you send us back the version, mm-hmm. it just really was,
oh,
everything made so much sense. And you really, like you put it on the, you put it on the next level.
Man, that means a lot to me. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. In the video, I think it's funny because we're not a couple,
yeah.
but we're doing a love song together.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, we have to sort of make it look a little bit like we have
yeah,
a situation,
chemistry,
a connection,
yeah.
and chemistry and all that. And I think we're good because I have the feeling we feel like old friends.
Yeah. I told you that I have a struggle with trying to be sexy. Hey, man, I think the video is a great showcase of like just innocent love, you know what I'm saying? I feel like we show it a lot, you know what I'm saying? In a very tasteful way. It's
yeah.
not corny, it's not...
Supernatural.
Yeah, exactly, you know? Exactly.
It means a lot to me that the song will be released on Motown. It means a lot to me that the record will be released in America, period.
Just period, yeah.
So, and then when Motown decided they wanted to work with me, I was like so shocked. Because I really didn't expect it. When I was working on the record, I didn't really work on the idea of releasing it in America. I just wanted to make the best music.
Mm-hmm. Again, I came up listening to gospel, the old school jazz and soul records. Motown is like a pinnacle of every black person's household in America, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta have Marvin Gaye, you gotta have Jackson 5, Stevie, Smokey Robinson, like all those people, man. So to just be aligned with such greatness, yeah, I'm super honored and grateful for Joy for bringing me a part of it.